Hey friends, this is Ron Deering coming to you from my home office in Coeur d'Alene, Idaho. Have you ever wanted to know what the best way to hold your home meetings to be the most successful? Well, stay tuned. We're going to talk about five tips for conducting an MLM home meeting. Welcome back. Every Friday, Ray Higdon has started doing free coaching Friday on Periscope, and it's just been incredible. And last Friday, what he actually does is he will just look at questions, and they're going by. You know, there's 200 or 300 people on there. The questions are popping up on Periscope, one right after the other. But he'll pick 2-3 of them and go through them. And he did last Friday did a ton of just great training, but one of the things that really hit me was he gave five tips for running a home party or a home meeting in your network marketing company, and they just really hit home with me because I've had to deal with them, I've had to use them, I've had to incorporate them into home meetings and home parties that I've done in the past and still in the future. So if you are not connect with Ray for his Periscope, you can go to rayhigdon.com/Periscope and start following him. That way you'll get a notification on your phone, on your pad, and so forth when he does these, but especially on Fridays. He does one pretty much every day. Now, that said, Jessica's about ready to have their new little baby Sabrina any day, so in fact, she's past due, so he may be done for a little while. But so let's talk about these five coaching tips. Now, first one he brought to our attention was train your team. And you might think, well, what does that mean, train your team? Well, one of the challenges I've had for a long time with team members is not knowing how to be a participant. We're not talking about them conducting the meeting, but not knowing how to be a participant. So you need to train them to show up even if they haven't got a prospect, because it's a team effort. Imagine going into a restaurant or a theater and you being the only one there, or maybe one or two of you. The first thing in your mind is, whoa, this may not be a good movie, or this may not be a good restaurant. So that synergy that you get with a lot of people, that maybe one or two prospects there and the rest are already reps in the company, but that synergy and that excitement and everything just makes things that much better. So train them to have the right culture, to act excited and engage with the speaker, laugh at the jokes even though you've heard them 100 times. Don't sit in the front row texting people or talking in the back and so forth. Be an active participant in the meeting. Be engaged, be excited, laugh at the jokes and so forth. Train them to never, ever, ever talk about disappointment. Oh, I had 5 people, but only 1 person. Can you imagine if you're that 1 person, what that feels like? I've had people sit there and get on the phone trying to, leave messages with people that didn't show up and everything. And the poor person that was there with them thinking, well, who am I? Chop liver? Be excited about the person that's there. Don't show any disappointment because you didn't have anybody or the people that you wanted to show up didn't show up, okay? And then train them to always edify the speaker, no matter what they may think about him or her, whether they don't like him. You just would be amazed at how many times I've heard people in the background talking and telling their people, well, yeah, so-and-so was going to be here, Ray was going to be here, but, Ron's the only one that showed up, but yeah, it should be pretty good. Don't ever do that. And the other thing that really he didn't bring this up, but this is one of my pet peeves, is if you're one of the participants and you're in the business, don't interrupt the speaker and don't ask questions that may cause someone to start doubting what's going on there. Keep those questions to yourself. I've had so many meetings where, one of my reps would raise his hand or interrupt me in the middle of the presentation and say, hey, but what about the monthly? Do you have to pay that all the time? And just, don't do it. You're ruining the meeting for everybody and everybody else that's brought prospects and so forth. All right, enough on that one. That's the big one. Number two, invite more than you want. We know it's a numbers game. We know that people are people. So if you want 3 people to be there, you better invite 10 to 15. People are just not going to show up. That's just the way it is, no matter what they tell you. So you need to invite more than you really want to be there. Number three is embrace the long term. And what he really meant by that is understanding that you're going to go through a lot of meetings where no one's going to show up. It's just going to happen. I can't tell you how many meetings I've had where I've invited people, and not one person showed up. Did I quit? No. Do I stop having them? No. You just keep moving on. If you are one of those people that somebody, you invite a bunch of people and they don't show up and you're ready to quit, then maybe this isn't a business for you. Maybe you should reconsider doing what you're doing and stick to the job. Okay. Number four, and this is a big one. He explained it's one of the people in our company, Ray and I happen to be in the same business, but that taught this, and it's called BAMFAM, B-A-M-F-A-M, and it stands for Book a Meeting from a Meeting. And the power in that is so great, because how awesome is it at the end of the meeting to say, hey, and guess what? Next week, Sandy is going to have a meeting at her house, and we hope that you can all be there. Bring your friends, bring new prospects, bring people that you know that need to see this. It can not only be done from a home meeting, but from a major event. You know, get your team together, get new people that have come, and book a meeting from that meeting. It creates momentum. It creates a forward path on which people can continue to go. You haven't stopped everything right off that meeting. And number five is help them with your vision. Help them to understand how vision is so important. Help them paint a vision to make themselves better. Help them to see why they should be around this campfire, be a part of this community because of where you're going, the vision you have to take the team. So I hope this has been something that will help you in your business of doing home business meetings. If you are in network marketing, which I'm assuming you are, and you're having a challenge getting leads or connecting with people, then please go to my website, rondeering.com, and opt in for the free video, which is going to teach you how to get more leads for your MLM business, recruit more people, and get some income coming in from those people that say no to joining you. Just put your name and your email, and I will send that to you for free. You have a great day, and God bless.